Good evening, everyone, and welcome to our forensic lab. My name is Yula, and I'll be your lab assistant tonight. I'm here to welcome you and answer any questions you have before we meet our main technician, Bridget. In this tutorial, we're going to learn to develop fingerprints on difficult surfaces, such as paper and fabric. Don't be alarmed if at any point during the demonstration you suddenly feel like you want to close your eyes, or like you're falling asleep. This is very common. We find the lab environment to be very relaxing, so this is a normal response. This is why we record all of our sessions, so that you can view them at a later date. Thank you for being here, and I hope you enjoy this visit. Because of its uniqueness, a fingerprint is often considered the most valuable type of evidence. Fingerprints can be found in objects we touch, and they can be used to identify us. Fingers contain a large amount of sweat pores. When a finger comes in contact with any surface, sweat is released from these pores, and the print is formed. Since sweat is colorless, the impressions it leaves are colorless. This is what we call latent fingerprints. The word latent describes something in the state of existing, but concealed. Our sweat contains water, minerals, and organic compounds. Its composition is affected by variables such as age, sex, diet, medication, state of mind, and the presence of contaminants. The composition and clarity of prints vary from person to person. Fingerprints quickly fade with time due to exposure to the elements. Because of this, it's one of the first pieces of trace evidence collected at a crime scene. Fingerprints can lead to significant conclusions in criminal cases, but it's also important to remember that forensic science is often used to put people in cages. Forensic science can be used to cause harm. For example, while the conventional use of DNA profiling was primarily aimed at the individual suspect, more recently, a shift of interest in forensic genetics has taken place, in which the population in the family to whom an unknown suspect allegedly belongs has moved center stage, coming to conclusions about the phenotype or the family relations of an unknown suspect produces suspect populations and families. It's also important to remember that forensic lab workers are regular people who make mistakes. Today we will learn an effective way to reveal a difficult print, an aged fingerprint on porous surface such as paper. This type of fingerprint fades quickly. For this process, we will use endandione, a chemical compound developed by scientists that reacts strongly with amino acids in a person's sweat and results in images of highly fluorescent fingerprint ridges. Now, I will pass you to our main technician, Bridget. We will first practice using endandione by developing freshly deposited fingerprints on a piece of white paper. These prints were deposited by our students only yesterday, and should be fairly easy to develop. This experiment will give you an idea of what you should be looking for when you work with actual evidence. Please take the time to study the texture and color of these bills in order to become acquainted with their surface. The paper contains a number of watermarks. Most notable one are rows of light and dark stars on a left to right diagonal. These particular bills were improperly stored, so they will not be used in our experiment. But they are identical to the evidence we will use in the end of the class. The evidence we will be working with in our class are paper bills that have been out of circulation for 30 years. These bills were used for monetary transactions in a country that no longer exists. This place, which ceased to exist in the year 1991, in the previous century, was different than most places in the world today. Its core values promoted a socioeconomic order built on the ideas of common ownership of the means of production. The absence of private property or social classes and hierarchies based on accumulation of wealth. Because these values were at odds with most of the world, a strict economic punishment was imposed by the world's most powerful empire. This punishment restricted necessary and consumer goods from being exported to this country. Although it made life considerably more isolated and difficult, the citizens of this place took pleasure in what remained available to them. Caring for nature. Feeding each other in difficult times. Working together, visiting those who share your values, growing your own food, taken trips with friends, mocking authority, becoming great at something you enjoy, flying through the air, sending a dog into space, daydreaming, dancing together, spending time with friends and learning new languages, loving each other in the spaces you share, spending time in nature, having a picnic, being young, having sex, being in love, being in love, being in love, giving a flower to someone you love, feeling happy for your friends, being in love, dreaming, going to the beach, spending a whole day at the beach, and then suddenly disappearing forever. Let's join Bridget now as she carefully makes a list of all the acquired equipment and checks her inventory for the items. Let's go over the list of the required items together. Sterile gloves. This is important because the materials we use are toxic and leave permanent marks on the skin. It's also important to protect the evidence from contamination. A sterilized surgical tray to submerge your piece of fingerprinted evidence. Sterilized curved edge stainless steel tongs. Blunt edge, sterilized, stainless steel tongs. Clean glass pipette for the distribution of the indendione compound over our testing material. Sterilized large surgical blunt edge scissors. Small surgical blunt edge scissors, also sterilized. A full bottle of indendione, the compound we will use to reveal the fingerprints. Our piece of evidence sealed for protection. In this case, it's a pack of pills that we've kept in optimal conditions for 3 decades. Orange barrier filter goggles for your eyes. The orange barrier filter will help you see the fluorescence of the fingerprints treated with indendione. It will also protect your eyes from the bright green light. A green light appears much brighter to our eyes than any other light. Human color vision is based on four types of receptors in the retina, rods, and three types of cones. Certain wavelengths, mostly around the yellow-green portion of the spectrum, are absorbed more strongly and by more types of cells than the rest. Because of this, a green light is almost painfully bright. And finally, our source of light in a 530 nanometers wavelength range that we will use to excite the luminescent reaction of indendione. To begin, let's take our evidence from its protective package carefully. Bridget will open the sealed package to show you the stack of bills you will be working with. separate the bills into smaller piles in order to create control groups, so that we could use different saturations of the compound on each pile. These separate stacks should be sealed in individual bags until we're ready to work with them. necessary precautions. You will need to wear gloves, and you will need to wear a protective face shield over your face to protect yourself from splashes. And now, carefully put the face shield over your face. Now, please put on a pair of strong, sterilized gloves. Print and dye-on reacts with the proteins in your skin, and it can leave permanent marks until those skin cells in your hands regenerate. When you're ready to begin our experiment, please place your surgical steel tray onto the table. Each student should place one piece of testing material in their tray. Now open the fresh bottle of indandyon provided in your kit and pour some of the liquid into the tray, enough to fully submerge the evidence. Make sure the paper is soaked all the way through on both sides. Some papers will need to be soaked more than once. When you finish soaking your piece of paper, please use the sterilized tongs to air dry it. Remove the piece of paper out of the tray and let it air dry on another surface before you continue. Now that we've treated our testing material, we need to apply dry heat to its entire surface in order to activate the chemical reaction. Normally we would use a forensic oven at 160 degrees Celsius, but for the purpose of this workshop, we're going to use an ordinary household iron with the steam option turned off. I recommend that you put the evidence between two pieces of paper in order not to scorch it. Apply heat from the iron for 45 seconds in circles. Now that we processed the first exhibit, we can see the visible color change, indicating finger impressions have been deposited and developed on the paper. Now, let's observe them under the fluorescence examination light. First, please protect your eyes by using the orange barrier goggles. I think we're ready to turn off the lights and turn on the forensic light source. Lights off, please. Now, turn on the green light. As you see, under the regular green light, there is no luminescence. However, when we put the orange barrier filter over our eyes, we can see a strong yellow fluorescence, indicative of fingerprint development on our exhibit. This fluorescent effect is important because it helps create strong detail when you photograph the fingerprints with your camera. Recording our findings is always the final step in this process. This is how we reveal fingerprints on porous surfaces. Indandione is a very effective compound. Now please join your work groups and start working with the evidence you were provided. If you have any questions, Bridget will remain in class until the end of the session. I hope this was a fun and informative class for you. Thank you all for being here, and good night. See you next week.